Okay, good afternoon. In the subject of engineering thermodynamics, today we are going to see one experiment that is a practical part. The title is flue gas analysis using ORSAT apparatus. Okay, now it is very general that we are talking about a flue gas, but there is a very confusing terms, fuel gas and flue gas. Okay, so the fuel gas means whenever we say that the fuel get burned, especially in a liquid or gaseous. So the fuel in liquid state, it is not going to burn. Fuel get vaporized and the vapor mixture with air get burned. So that is called the fuel gas. When we said flue gas, so flue gas means the exhaust gases, hot burning gases. That is called the flue gases. So whenever suppose any fuel get burned in a furnace, it might be a coal, it might be any liquid fuel, it might be any gaseous fuel. So whenever that fuel get burned, so hot flue gases are evolved. And that hot flue gases delivering its heat for the intended purpose. Suppose it is used for a boiler, so it deliver heat to generate a steam, and the exhausted flue gases that having some sort of heat itself, some combustion products just like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, other gases along with oxygen, some part, suppose excess air is there, so oxygen will be there, nitrogen will be there. So the flue gases is a combination of number of product of combustion of that fuel. So we have to do the analysis of that flue gases. Now there are various instruments to analyze the flue gases, exhaust gases, but the simplest method, that is a ORSAT apparatus. And it is restricted to analyze only to content of oxygen. So oxygen, how much is the content in your flue gas? Second, content of your CO2 in your flue gas and content of CO. So by using this ORSAT apparatus, we can measure how much amount of these gases are there, and by difference we come to know how much is the remaining N2. So N2 we are not going to measure. Actually, it is a difference of total gas minus addition of these three gas. So whatever be the remaining part, we assume that is completely N2 gas. Okay. So ORSAT apparatus is a apparatus which is used to analyze the flue gas. And what it analyzes? So it analyzes the content of CO2, O2, and CO in your flue gas, exhaust gases. And on the basis of that, we can calculate how much is the content of N2. Let us see what is the exact apparatus is there. So it might be possible in a 12th or 11th, you already saw this kind of setup. This is the ORSAT apparatus. In this, there is a flue gas supply intake, you can say inlet is provided. So whatever be the flue gases is there, we attach that pipe to here, this U-tube, glass U-tube is there. And in this U-tube glass, there is glass wool and calcium chloride. Glass wool is provided to filter your flue gases. Filter, that means purify the flue gases. That means it is not chemically changing the composition of flue gas. It is just simply, you can say, working as a filter. So whatever be the soot particle, carbon particles, heavy carbon particle, dust particles, so they get arrested. So clean exhaust gas is allowed to pass through this glass wool. So glass wool just simply working as a filter. and calcium chloride. So many time we, even though in automobile you observe that from the silencer pipe you found that there is a dripping of water particles, the silencer tail end pipe. So how that water particle is there? Because whatever be the fuel, diesel or petrol burn in the your IC engine, that produce the exhaust gases, and that exhaust gases passing through silencer and then come to tailpipe. But we observe that there is a dripping of some droplets, water droplets from that tailpipe. So that water droplets is nothing but during a combustion, whatever be the water vapors form. When that water vapors come in a contact of cold surrounding air at the opening of that tailpipe, so it get condensed, and so we observe that there is a wetness or there is a drop of waters. So same way, during the combustion of any fuel in a boiler, there is a lot of possibility that water vapors will be there. Definitely it is there. So we have to remove that moisture content. So we provide calcium chloride. So when your flue gas pass through this YouTube channel, so glass will filter that flue gas, calcium chloride absorb the water content, absorb the moisture. So ultimately outlet of this YouTube is a clean exhaust gas, clean flue gas and dry state, because moisture already arrested here with the help of calcium chloride. Now we have dry and clean exhaust gas. Next, there is a three-way cock. Now three-way cock, how it is working? If I set this three-way cock, first position will be whatever be the supply from this YouTube, it will through this three-way cock, it will come and move this way. So this is first. This is also possible if I change the position of this three-way cock. So whatever be the content from right hand side, it will be travel through this three-way cock and exhausted. And third position is either content from left side, it will flow directly to right side through this three-way cock. That means three-way cock behave in three direction. Either it will exhaust from left to exhaust or right to exhaust, or it will pass through three-way cock to second side. In both side it is possible, that means left to right or right to left. So this is the function of three-way cock. Next, this three-way cock, this horizontal tube is there. This tube having a three branches, and each branches having a two-way cock. Two-way cock, it is simply a on-off kind of cock. Either it will on the supply or it will off the supply. And with this two-way cock, there are three bulbs are there. 1, 2, 3, that glass bulbs are there. But that is not the empty. Each glass bulb having a different solution. First glass bulb having a KOH solution. So when we talking about a KOH, so KOH having a tendency to absorb CO2 gas. So if your exhaust gas, flue gas having a CO2 content, and if that exhaust gas passing through this first glass bulb, so KOH solution get absorb that CO2. Second bulb having alkaline pyrogallic acid. When your flue gases passing through this second bulb, so if there is any O2, then it get absorbed. Many time in oral or practical exam it is asked that only O2 absorb or any O2 is absorbed by alkaline pyrogallic acid or that second bulb. So I am saying any O2. That means if you allow your exhaust gas directly pass to this second tube, second bulb. So no doubt, whatever be the independent oxygen is there, that is O2, it get absorbed. Along with that, if there is CO2, so from CO2 again there is a O2, so that O2 again get absorbed. So we cannot directly send your exhaust gas to second bulb. If we send our exhaust gas to second bulb, then O2 from CO2 as well as free oxygen O2 get absorbed. So we don't get how much was the CO2, because from CO2 the O2 content get absorbed here. So there is a fixed sequence. Whenever we supplied any exhaust gas for RSAT apparatus to analyze it, so the sequence is fixed. We allow our flue gas first to this KOH bulb, then alkaline pyrogallic acid bulb, and last we allow to this third bulb, and this third bulb having anomical cuprous chloride. And this solution is used to absorb CO. So it get absorb all CO content. CO content, it doesn't mean only carbon monoxide. It going to absorb C and O. So if we directly supply our flue gas to this third bulb, so flue gas having CO2, from that CO2 C get absorbed. O2 is there, from O2 O get absorbed. So we cannot get the correct reading for oxygen level and CO2 level. So there is a fixed sequence, 1, 2, 3. We have to allow flue gases in this sequence only. In turn, not simultaneously, in turn. First we allow whole exhaust gas to pass through this first bulb. Then we close first bulb. Then whole exhaust gas pass through the second bulb. Then after that, we close that cock, then allow for third bulb likewise. Now in the apparatus, next part is gas burette. So whatever be the flue gas we are supplying or taking as a sample, so it should be a known value. So known volume we allow for the analysis. So how we come to know how much is the gas is there? So there is a gas burette which is calibrated. Outside this gas burette, there is a large size tube, glass tube is there, which is filled with water. So before starting our equipment experiment, we have to fill this outside glass bulb with water. What is the use of that? So it is maintaining constant temperature. Otherwise, absorbing ability gets changed. Whatever be the your flue gas is there, if its temperature going to change, so it's get absorbed, that tendency get changed. So you don't get the correct readings. So we have to maintain the constant temperature. For that purpose, we use a water jacket. Now here, this gas burette is surrounded by water jacket. Whatever be the inlet, it is directly going to gas burette, and the second end of this gas burette, it is attached to this rubber tube. That means water jacket is not connected with this gas burette or intake or outlet. It is simply for cooling purpose. Now the second end of this gas burette, which is connected to this tube, this tube is attached to one leveling bottle. Now this is the actual leveling bottle which is used to measure how much is the amount, because gas itself, it is transparent, so we can't observe the level of gas, but we can observe the level of water. So we pour water in this leveling bottle. Now imagine if I pour the water in leveling water and I rise this level of this bottle, that means I am just picking this water bottle and rise its level. So what happens? Water will start moving and it will enter into this gas burette, because I am rising the level of this water bottle. So whatever be the water inside the bottle, it is shifting to gas burette. That means your gas burette going to filled with water. Now during conducting this experiment, okay, how to conduct the experiment? So during conducting this experiment, so at the beginning, how to start? So we have our flue gas supply, we attach to this U-tube, but we are not allowing this flue gas to pass through the whole system. At beginning, we open this three-way cock and allow whatever be the air, whatever be the content on this right hand side to move out. So our three-way cock position is like that. Right side can be, whatever be the fluid can be move out. We close this three two-way cock, that means there is no supply to any bulb. Then whatever be the water filled in leveling bottle, we picked up this leveling bottle and rise its level. That's when we just picked that bottle and lifted. So as we lifted this water bottle, so water level will start increasing in this gas burette. We can observe that from outside, that gas burette is filled by water slowly, 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 slowly. And whatever be the air inside this tubing, this air will escape from this three-way cock, and we rise this bottle till our water level reach to this three-way cock. Once our water start moving out from this three-way cock, that time we close this three-way cock. That means complete system on right hand side is filled with water except this bulb. So whatever be the channel, whatever be the branches are there, completely filled with water. Now in this position we close our three-way cock. After that we lower this bottle. So as we lower the bottle, the water inside this whole tubing will decrease. As it is going to decrease level, no doubt there will be a vacuum created. At the same time, we adjust our three-way cock in a such a way that the exhaust gas can be entered to right-hand side tubing. So as the water bottle lowers, so water inside the right-hand side branches will move back. There will be an empty space. That empty space will be filled by this flue gases, and we allow this till our water will lower to certain height. Suppose this is the initial reading of burette, so we allow our water to lower and reach to this level. When our water reach to this bottom level, that means your complete right hand system is filled by that exhaust gas, filter and dry exhaust gas. When our water level reach to this level, then we close three-way cock. Now at this instant, our whole right hand side tubing branches and this gas burette is filled with exhaust gas, and water level reached to this. Suppose this is zero reading. water level zero, that means up to this there is certain volume of exhaust gas. That exhaust gas, suppose we are considering 30 ml, suppose it is in volume definitely. So suppose 30 ml, total volume of this is 30 ml. So we take a exhaust or flue gas sample as 30 ml. Now two way valve come in a role. As I said, there is a sequence. So first, second, third. So three way cock is off, complete right hand side branch and burette is filled with your flue gas, and suppose that total quantity is 30 ml. After that, we allow to pass this flue gas through first bulb. So we operate this two way cock, and now two way cock is open. So your flue gas can enter into this bulb. This bulb having a KOH solution. Now, but why that gas will enter? So again, we rise the level of this water bottle. As we rise the level of water bottle, so water will insert in this gas burette. So water will lift it. Now, if water is lifted, that means it pushing exhaust gas. And your first bulb wall is, cock is open. So whatever be the rise in water, it is actually pushing exhaust gas, and that exhaust gas sample is actually entering to your first bulb. When your water level reach to this level, that means almost all exhaust gas is already enter into the first bulb. That time we close this cock. Now your right hand side whole system having water, complete your exhaust gas flue gas sample is inside your first bulb where there is a KOH solution. Now KOH solution absorbs CO2 gas. Now whatever be the CO2 contained in your flue gas get absorbed in your first bulb. After that, after some time, we lower this water bottle. So water from tubing will again lower and come back to bottle. That time we open this cock. So as water level returns, so your exhaust gas moving out. But this moving out exhaust gas or flue gas don't have a CO content because it is already get absorbed. So exhaust gas with another composition, with other composition move out. CO get absorbed itself in bulb one. Now, how much we have to lower this water bottle? We lower this water bottle to initial position. That means our water level should be this much at the beginning. But as whatever be the volume of CO get absorbed, so your gas volume reduce because that much amount of CO already get absorbed. So your gas volume is reduced. So due to reduction of gas volume, suppose this much is the reduction of gas volume because this much was the actual CO2 which is get absorbed. So your gas volume reduce. So there is a negative pressure. So your water lifted up. And how much is get lifted? The quantity of CO2 removed. So CO2 get absorbed, that much amount of volume is empty now. So that amount of volume get filled by water. So from this, we can come to know that how much is the CO2? Suppose this is 7 ml. So at the beginning, total gas sample is 30 ml. When water level is this, after flue gas passing through bulb one, when I come back again, so I observe that there is a increase in water level due to absorption of CO2. I again put back my water bottle to this stand, but this time water level is not reached to initial, it is lifted up. Why lifted? Because CO2 get absorbed and that much amount volume is reduced, so it create a negative pressure and my water get lifted here. So the level change in water is nothing but a amount of CO2. So out of 30, 7 ml is amount of CO2. Now second time I close this first bulb cock and open this second bulb cock, and again I repeating the same process. Again I lifting this water bottle, rise its level. So water will insert in this gas burette, then through this glass tubes, and as second cock is open, so this flue gas will enter into second bulb, and I will allow this gas to flow in second bulb till your water reach to this level. At that time I will close this cock. That means total volume of exhaust gas is filled in this bulb 2. Now bulb 2 having second solution, pyrogallic acid, so it is going to absorb O2. Now whatever be the excess oxygen is there in flue gases, that much amount of O2 get absorbed by that pyrogallic acid. When I lower my water bottle, water level is decreasing, that time I again open this cock. Now exhaust gas or flue gases return back to the burette, gas burette, but already O2 get absorbed. So whatever be the O2 volume is there in flue gas, that much is absorbed, so there is again negative pressure up to that, so my water level will increase. Even though I put my water bottle to same position, but this time again water level in gas burette is increased. How much it is going to increase? Whatever be the amount of oxygen is there, so oxygen get absorbed, so that much volume water will increase in gas burette. Suppose it is 5 ml. So I can say that the 5 ml is the oxygen content. Now the third time, repeating the same process, third time I will open this third cock, rising the bottle. Whatever be the flue gas, it is going to insert in third bulb. When water reach to this cock level, that time I will close this cock. So gas remain in third bulb. Third bulb having its own specific solution, and it is going to absorb CO gas. After some time, I will lower this water bottle, so whatever be the water inside this tubing will returning back to bottle. That time I will open this cock, so flue gas will again enter into this burette, but this time whatever be the volume of CO is there, it get absorbed, so that much volume is decreased in flue gas, so that much volume of water will increase in gas burette. If I calibrated burette is there, so if I calculate or measure it, suppose it is 6 ml, so I can say that 6 ml was the CO. Now 7 ml CO2, 5 ml O2, 6 ml CO. So whatever be the remaining amount of this gas, initially we take a sample of 30 ml. 30 minus 7 ml minus 5 ml minus 6 ml. So whatever be the remaining amount, it is nothing but a N2 gas. So for N2 measurement, we don't have any separate bulb. We measure N2 by the difference of volume absorbed by these three bulbs. So from this, we come to know how much was the CO2 in your flue gas, how much was the O2 in your flue gas, and how much was the CO in your flue gas. And by difference, we come to know remaining is the N2. Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, then I will play one video which is explaining the same thing. After that video, we will.
This problem. How are you going to analyze the flue gas? What you have to do is you have to pass on the flue gas in this particular YouTube section. So first, YouTube, your aim is to get the pure and dry flue gas, right? So in order to maintain the purity, that means it should not have a dust particle or a smoke particle at all. What you can add here is you can keep glass wool in this YouTube. Glass wool is just like a wool particle, but it is you know made up of glass. So very very fine particles of glass is used to make this wool. Now you imagine if the gas is passing through this and if it looks like wool, so obviously the solid particles, soot, smoke particles, dust, dirt will be entangled here. It will not allow those particles to pass through and your gas will be obviously pure, right? So to maintain that purity, we use glass wool. And what about dry? That means the flue gas should not have moisture in it. And obviously we are going to use that anhydrous calcium chloride solution. So anhydrous calcium chloride is also placed inside and with that you'll be able to know how much moisture is present in this flue gas sample. Now that flue gas comes here, your aim is to analyze the flue gas. So if you allow the flue gas to enter from this three-way stopcock, yet the entire apparatus is still filled with air, right? It is still filled with air. So what we want is we need to evacuate the air and create a vacuum. So the first step is before allowing the flue gas to enter into the apparatus, we should evacuate the air which is already present. Otherwise, your estimation of CO2, O2, etc. will vary, right? So what we'll do is, we'll close this knob of three-way stopcock. We'll open this knob of three-way and we'll open this way. What we have done, out of these three ways, we have closed this portion. We have opened this and we have opened this. Two ways are open for this three-way stopcock. Now what you can do is, you start filling your water from the water reservoir. This water will come down and it will start moving in the burette. It will start filling this particular portion, obviously. So when you keep on increasing the water level, it will start filling the entire apparatus. And what you have to do, when the water is coming from behind, obviously the air is going. You are pushing the air. Where? You are pushing the air here. So since this gate is open, the air which has been pushed by this water, I'm adding water from here. So obviously the water level is rising in this apparatus and obviously the air is going. Where it is going? It is evacuating from this hole, vented hole, right? What you have to do? You have to fill this with water. So till you see the water here, you just keep on adding water from here so that the entire apparatus is filled with water now and the air is already gone. Right? So now the entire apparatus is filled with water. Now if you see back, these things I'm saying. So if you open this particular knob, the entire apparatus will be filled with water. Since this is made up of glass, you'll be able to see that the water is coming in this portion. And the moment the water came here, now, you just have to stop now this particular gate. And now what you'll do? You'll close this gate. And now you open this and this is already open, right? So now you open this, allow your flue gas to enter. But then flue gas, how will it enter? It does not have a space because water is already here. So what you'll do, you'll take your water level back. So water reservoir, the role would be to insert the water and to take the water back. So we are going to do this. We are going to add the water. We are going to take the water. What we are doing now, we are going to take the water back. And slowly, slowly, when the water is going back, flue gas will start taking its position. So now you have to continue doing that till the entire apparatus is filled with your flue gas. Now, what is the boundary? Till what you have to do? So if you remember, like there was a burette here, right? So when the burette is here, right, like this, if a burette is there, what you have to do? You have to fill the flue gas till the last point of the burette. And before that, below that, there will be water. So here there is water. But here, till here, there is flue gas. So your entire apparatus from here to here, flue gas is already filled. So the moment you see that the water level is reached till here, you just close this door. So now the role of three-way stopcock is over. The role was to create a vacuum in the apparatus and allow the flue gas to enter in the apparatus. So this is what is done. Now your complete apparatus is filled with flue gas. You have to start the analysis. So the first step is done. Second step is to analyze them. How are you going to analyze? With the help of these three containers. So you have container number 1, 2 and 3. What you will do is, you want the gas to go in one container at a time. So let's say this is two-way stopcock. Let's say I open this gate. Now when I open this, obviously gas will find a space to move and it will start moving in the container, right? But I want to ensure that the entire flue gas has gone in the one container. How can I do that? Yes, you are right. I will again add water. I'll keep on adding water so that the water forces flue gas to move out. And where it will go? Obviously, the place is first container. We have to do this process till the water come here. Now, if you see, your entire apparatus is now filled with water. And where is the flue gas now? The flue gas has entered in the container number 1. Right? So now in one container, your flue gas has entered. What have you taken in one container is a known amount of KOH. And I guess you remember when we were doing leavings apparatus in ultimate analysis, we found that KOH absorbs CO. So what happens is the KOH present in the solution will absorb CO. So the second step is to estimate how much CO2 is present in the flue gas. Right? So now your flue gas is inside. Now how will you know how much CO2 is there? What you'll do is, now you will again take your water level back and the flue gas will start coming out. So you have to again take your flue gas out. Once you take the flue gas out, you will see that the water level is like this much raised. Water level is this much raised means this much water has come down. That means this much flue gas has not came back from one container. Earlier the flue gas was till the last point of the burette, but now when you've taken your flue gas back, it has not taken that much portion. Why? Because that much portion is CO2 which is absorbed in KOH, and that is why it did not came back. So from this volume of the burette, we'll be able to understand that how much CO2 is present, right? Now, you'll close this knob and open the knob of the second container. So now when you open the knob of the second container, you will see? Obviously, the flue gas will go to the second container. So now if I open this knob, then the flue gas has found its space. It will start entering in the second container. How will you tell the flue gas to go? Again, you'll increase the water level. So increase the water level till the flue gas moves in the second container and close it, right? And close it. Now the entire flue gas is inside second container where we take alkaline pyrogallic acid. And obviously it absorbs some gas which is nothing but oxygen. So now we'll estimate how much oxygen is present in this flue gas. How? The entire flue gas is inside this chamber. Now you take your flue gas back. How will you take that? You just take the flue gas back by reversing the water action. So you tend the flue gas to come out by the force of water. You will take it back. And now you will see that the water level is this much raised. Earlier it was here and now it is here. That means this much gas has not come back. And obviously where it is gone in second container. Now which gas it was? Obviously oxygen, because it absorbs oxygen. So from the volume of this burette, I'll be able to understand how much oxygen is present in this sample. And the same goes for the third container, that close this door and you open this one. And now let the gas go in the third container. Here you have ammonical cuprous chloride solution, and that is going to give you amount of CO present. So when you take it back, you'll realize that this much amount is raised, and whatever is raised is proportional to the amount of CO formed, right? So with the help of this graduated burette, we'll be able to understand how much these gases are present. And then whatever nitrogen is present, that you may use by subtracting them. Water, CO2, O2, CO, you just add them, subtract it from 100, you'll get the amount of nitrogen present in the flue gas. Now, what is the role of this water jacket? Why are you keeping your burette inside this particular water jacket? Because the water jacket is actually maintaining the temperature constant, right? So we want a constant temperature. That is why you have actually immersed this burette in a water jacket, so that from outside there is no increase or decrease in the temperature. Because I guess you remember, with respect to temperature, the solubility of gas in water is affected, right? So if I increase the temperature, the fuel gas may get dissolved in the water, and it will lead to false estimation. So we need to maintain the constant temperature. That's why we keep it in a water jacket. So what is the role of water jacket? I hope you understand. Now, what is the role of water reservoir? Obviously, that was the main portion from which we were regulating the supply of water inside and outside. So I think with that,